turns into turn three. Here comes the 37 of Rob Mayo. Look at the big move by Campos, and
it all comes together.
Oh, a flip down in turns one and two.
When they shoot out the lights,
John Campos upside down, red flag is out.
50,000 watts of power.
Look at the response of that safety team.
And it's pushing all the load.
Our extreme fire and rescue, the best in the business.
Live from the Jetstream Aqua Massage Studio, you're listening to Northwest Dirt News on Speaker Radio.
Welcome back to Corvallis, Oregon, from the AMCO Transmissions Total Cars Care Studio.
Total Cars Care?
Total Car Care Studio. The studio tonight, myself, Corey Penfold, Warren Simpson, Dom Conti. It's been a long week, I will say that. All the action we've had in different parts of the country is the Moxie crew was split with Warren taking off to do some of that, what is that, asphalt?
It's NASCAR.
Oh, yeah, NASCAR. That's what it is.
Yeah, yeah, don't play dumb with me. You'll lose.
So it has been, and we're going to talk about that, Warren. I want to hear your experience. Because you guys were down at Roseville Speedway, right?
Roseville and Sacramento, yeah.
Okay.
That was the last race anyway.
Very cool.
Yeah.
I'm hoping that we've got some sound out there because normally right about this time, the Sweer Trucking chat line lights up. And
can you hear me?
I can hear you loud.
Awesome.
Sometimes it lights up because there is no sound, so maybe it's a good thing we're not hearing anything
well,
yet.
Well, I'm hoping that is the case here. So,
anyway. For those of you that missed my smart-ass mouth, I'm back.
That's funny. So, and it's going to be a good show. We don't have Joel. Joel's off making a business deal somewhere. Who knows? He's entering a big venture. So I want to start the show like we normally do. And Dom, I'm going to start with you. How was your week?
Oh, I had a wonderful week. Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and part of Sunday, I got to have the days off from work. And we went down to Bakersfield, had a wonderful weekend at actually Thursday, Friday, Saturday, had a wonderful time. Got to work with a lot of people. We got to help a lot of people. We raised some money for a charity.
Yes, we did.
For Bailey. Met some great people. Seen a lot of great racing. Just unbelievable weekend. Unbelievable.
Awesome. We've got good sound. Thank you, Tim Archer from Archer Floor Coverings. He hits us up on the Sweer Trucking chat line. Says good sound.
Well, that's
right
good enough.
Thank you.
We did. We had a great time. Warren. Are you still?
Yeah, that's good.
We can okay.
That's fine. Warren's much more important.
No.
I am too.
We're all equal here at Moxie.
That's right.
But Warren,
that's right.
You got to run off and do some NASCAR stuff.
I've been running with
Cody Vanderwall.
Right. I've been running with that team since August 12th, I think it was, when we ran Monroe.
Yep.
And I've been with them ever since.
From Monroe to Meridian, Idaho, and down to
Roseburg. To Meridian to Roseville.
Roseville, have, California.
In 2 weeks, we have the final race at Kern County in Bakersfield.
Yes.
So I'll be in Bakersfield soon.
So he just missed our Bakersfield
yes,
trip.
Yes, he did.
You know what? I was watching you guys on Facebook and everything. I saw all that you was doing. I was a little bit envious, but I was still doing what I like the best and rolling with a NASCAR.
Well, it sounds like you guys are having some success. I mean, you're building on a young driver who Cody Vanderwall is what we're talking about.
16 years old.
He has
more miles in a race car than he does a street car.
Isn't that funny?
That is.
Isn't that funny? But you know, you go online, you read about Cody. This kid, from what I can tell, and from what you guys are talking about, what I've read. We're going to see this kid on Sunday.
Oh, I think so. I think so.
I mean, from what I've read and the things that people are saying about him, he sounds like the real deal. I mean, like
he really has a knack. I mean, we went to just starting out at Monroe. I'd never even met him before Monroe, and I heard Jason Dickinson talk about him quite a bit, you know. But I'd never met him, and he goes out there on the track. Never seen that. That's a big 5/8. You know, that's a pretty good sized track there at Monroe, and he just took to it like. I mean, we were sixth in practice, and I think we qualified sixth. You know, he adapts to any track he goes to. He immediately sees where other guys are running. He pays attention and he learns from them. You know, and that's what anybody has to do. You know, you gotta
pick it up quick, adapts, and gets up on the wheel. And
Well, you got the McAnally, all the McAnally cars leading the way pretty much. You know, they're 1, 2, 3 in points, I believe.
Well, and on that series, that's fairly typical.
Yeah,
I mean, those
yeah.
are the those
oh.
are the.
Oh, they're doing a great job. Yeah. Not putting them down by no means, but, you know, we've had a chance to go out there and follow Todd Gilliland around a little
sure.
bit and learn
yeah.
from him.
There's a name that we've heard in that series for years with it was his dad. Was
David Gilliland.
David,
yeah.
Yeah,
yeah. He was down there.
yeah.
We spent the best part of 2 weeks at Bill McAnally Racing with using their facility because so the car wouldn't have to go back to Colorado. And I mean, they have a pull down machine that you mount on the frame rails and it pulls it down. It tells you your acumen, your toe. And I mean, just all this crazy information on a graph, you know, and it's like, wow, I don't even know how to read it. You know, I'm like, okay, this is cool.
Very cool.
Way above me, but
what a facility that McAnally's got.
Oh my gosh. I mean, he, excuse me, all the concrete's polished.
Yeah.
And the place is spick and span. You want to do any bit of grinding, you go to the fab shop. You push your car from where it is out to the fab shop, which isn't a long ways, but they're very tidy with their stuff around there and very respectfully so. You know, I mean, it's a cool facility.
Nice.
Bill McAnally's top notch.
So you guys spent some time down there working on the cars.
Yeah.
I know that off the air we talked about you guys doing some new setup type stuff to put under Cody to see what he liked, what he doesn't like.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Got some advice from the McAnally gang
right.
kind of on that chassis you guys are working with. And,
yeah.
What kind of feedback did Cody give you?
Ty Joyner ran the pull-down machine. That is Junior Joyner, Matt Crafton's crew chief.
Right.
That's his brother. And what a great guy. Everybody down there was so hospitable. I got to give them a shout-out. You know, if any of them are listening, you guys are awesome. And thank you for everything. So, now, what was the question? How did you like it?
Well, yeah, because you did. You put now. Well, we were talking off the air, and you tried something different that Cody probably hasn't had underneath him on that race car yet, setup wise.
Yeah. Well, he adapts to whatever we give him, and like at Roseburg, man, the car was out to lunch, and we couldn't figure out why. I mean, Jason and I had worked on it in Portland for a week and a half, and had it all set up, and come to find out an upper control arm had froze up and wasn't allowing it to move, you know, not absolutely frozen, but it was real rigid. Mm-hmm. So that we were out to lunch at Roseburg. Nobody knew why, and finally figured that out. But Cody adapts to anything you put under him. You know, we're looking at possibly running East or maybe some ARCA races next season. Rudy and Cody and Jason McGriff Dickinson is they're all down in Kansas right now. That's where the Cup's at this weekend and mm-hmm. the ARCA, and so they're looking at the setup procedures or the tech procedures rather, and hopefully they find us some sponsorship down there because you know it's pretty spendy to run this the K&N West.
Oh,
you know,
man, that's
and I can't imagine running the East. It's going to be a little bit more
right
if we end up doing that. But gosh, anybody out there that wanting to get on board with a great team, great family, my hat's off to that family. They're the most wonderful people you'd ever want to meet.
Mm-hmm.
Anybody interested in wanting to get in on a young driver that's going places, Cody Vanderwall, give him a call. You know, those guys are the real deal.
And it sounds like it.
Yeah.
No doubt. So
we're 8th in points right now, by the way.
That's not bad.
That's respectable. You
well,
know,
you're talking about a 16-year-old kid. I mean,
right,
if
right.
somebody was a 10-year veteran that's been around, had some major sponsorship, yeah, 8th place is, you know, 8th place.
Yeah, yeah.
But with a 16-year-old kid, we're talking about running against some established competition, some
right.
stout guys that
very.
Know their way around a race car. I would be, I'd be happy with that.
Yeah.
It's at this point.
Very respectable.
Very cool.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Glad to hear it. So my week.
How's your week been, Corey?
It's been, well, the last, I'd say about the last 8-9 days have been good. Good. We left a week ago today for the Budweiser Nationals. Everything went smooth at the airport.
Oh, yeah.
Nobody got the terrorist search or the rubber glove. I think Joel was disappointed by that. But
yeah. Poor guy's not here to finish.
Yeah, I know. I'm bad. Bad move.
No. That's legal. He should have been here.
Everything went good at the airport, and we got all of our equipment through, and we had to now I'm going to back this up here a little bit. I'm going to kind of go through my trip here. I'm going to go through the first, I don't know, 8-10 hours getting down there. So we leave. We get all the equipment packed up, and we get up there, and now we're going, okay, we've got all this
up
stuff.
Portland?
Portland, yeah,
okay.
Up to Portland. We get all this stuff out, and we've got luggage, and we're like, okay, what are we going to do? How are we going to do this? Because we're not checking the sound equipment in. We're not doing that, okay?
Yeah, absolutely.
There's
not.
Just too much money wrapped up in this stuff for these guys to be tossing these bags around. So Sandy and I checked in our big bag. I carried a bag. She carried a carry-on. So we each had a carry-on.
Yeah.
Dom says, well, I've got my carry-on. I'll take one. Joel says, well, I got to take one. We had an extra bag. We don't know how we're going to do this. Well, you remember Kelly and Jared on the flight last year.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
So Kelly shows up. He's like, dude, give me a bag. I'll carry it on. And so I'm like, perfect. So we get on the plane.
That was one full of dope.
So we get – you're carrying that one, Kelly.
Yeah.
So we get on the plane, and you know us. You know how we do it on the plane. We get up there. And
oh, yeah.
And
yeah, I was a designated driver last year, so
right.
I know how you guys do it. Yeah.
So immediately we realize, okay, we're here to have fun. Unfortunately, the wife of the family sitting directly ahead of Kelly, who is next to us on our row, just happened to be, of all people, Cruella DeVille. She is an angry, angry
oh,
individual.
No. Oh, no.
This lady, and I'm going to say something on the
Cruella.
Air. That, yeah, that's her. She looked like her even. So I'm watching this lady as we're making comments. She's rolling her eyes and she's, you know, just totally livid, you know, how we do it. You know, a couple of drinks in and, you know. So I'm thinking, okay, I'm up here in the air. This lady's like really killing the vibe. We're trying to have some fun. And you know how Kelly is. Kelly, there's no filter on Kelly.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, we love the guy. But so I look over and, you know, my famous line, what is it? What do I do when we're in public to try to embarrass you?
Oh, how's that rash?
Yeah, I look over at Kelly, and knowing Kelly's going to probably unleash the beast when I say this, right? I see what's coming. I look over and I go, hey, Kelly, did you ever get that rash cleared up? What does Kelly respond with out loud on the plane? He goes, oh, you mean the one on my...
Oh, no.
This lady's head snapped. And the plane erupted in laughter. That poor lady could not wait to get off that airplane, and we're barely off the ground, right?
You guys are mean.
So a couple drinks in, you know, we fly down and have a good time. We get our rental, and rental was in my name, so I drive it out of the stop, back, pump the brakes, let's hit reverse. We get off the plane, and there's that little bar, that little restaurant we ate at last year. Remember that?
In Fresno.
Yes, in Fresno.
Yeah.
We go in, and we all sit down. We're all hungry. We all have a burger, good food.
Yeah.
Burgers, fries, iced teas, you know, having a good time. We leave. We get all of our
iced tea, Long Island iced
teas? No. Dom didn't drink because he was... DD.
That's right.
So I had a burger, and I did have an IC, regular IC. We leave. We get out. We get all booked in. We get our car, you know, our luggage in, and we drive. As we're pulling out, the first sign hit me that I don't feel good. As we were coming down, I started getting a migraine.
Here's your sign.
I had a bit of about halfway through the flight, I got a headache. As we're coming down, it got worse and got worse and got worse, and my ears popped. I had a bad migraine. I ate this burger. We down the road we go. We get up to the stop sign, or the little gas station, and we pull in. Dom and I switch. I get in the back, and we're cruising.
I saw a picture of that.
And as we're driving down Highway 99, 80, 85 miles an hour, just cruising, keeping up with traffic, I realize there's going to be a very bad start to this trip.
Uh-oh.
I do not feel good. My stomach is something's brewing, buddy.
Dom? Pull over.
No, we're driving. I'm in the back seat. I've got my eyes closed, and I'm going, oh, this is not good. This is not good. And as I look up, I can see a sign that says exit. I said, Dom, how close is that exit? He goes, it's right up here. And about that time, my mouth waters, and I know what's coming. I roll the window. I said, get to that exit. I am hanging out the window at 80, 85 miles an hour, and I'm hurling. Cars are switching lanes. I painted our SUV.
Down the driver's side?
Oh, down the whole left rear quarter. I painted it. It was a different color. Cars are switching lanes. It's all over the windshield of the car behind us. I feel bad for these people. Horrible, horrible start. We pull over, get some water. Dom, being the nice guy that he is, goes and buys 2 gallons of water and rinses off the chunks, right? So we get back in
the car. Did the car have California plates
on? It did.
Good.
Yeah.
Good.
I feel good now that I've just let go of everything that I've eaten in Fresno, and I feel good. Getting